I'm going to give you a very quick demonstration of how to draft these pants. Now, we'll have much more detailed instructions and a better video later that will give you a detailed step-by-step. But for this video, we're just going to take a look at the preliminary concepts. We're going to start our pants draft with the leg center line. This is going to be our primary leg center line. So if I can get you to step down, I will draw the leg center line. So what we're going to do is we're going to measure from the waist, and I'm just using the waistline that we have here of this pair of pants. We're going to measure the length, and then I'm going to mark this length on the pattern. Okay? And that tells us the pants length. Now, the next thing that we're going to do is we are going to measure down to the hip level. And let me get you to come over, and I'm going to take you from the side. And what we're looking for with the hip level is the fullest part of the hips. So we're going to measure from the waist to the hips, okay, and get you to step off, and we're going to mark that one. Let's go. So here's our waistline. Here is our hip line. Now, in order to determine where the leg is going to start, where the torso ends and the leg starts, we're going to measure what I call the crotch depth. So, you sit on the side, and the crotch depth is measured from the waist down to a flat surface where you're sitting, and we can put that right here, draw a line there. And we'll call, I'm going to abbreviate this T for thigh, H for hip, and this is the center of our leg. Down at the bottom we have the cuff, and for this we're just going to use a standard measurement. Okay? And put 4 inches over here, 4 inches over here. Now we need to determine the measurements of the body. So if I can get you to come over, you don't have to stand up. Just come over here, and we're going to measure around the thigh. Now, notice that the thigh for the front pattern is only half the body. So what we can do here is we can take the thigh measurement and get you to move to the side. And this is the width of our thigh. If we fold it in our tape measure in fourths, we can mark the thigh here and the thigh here. And that's the thigh measurement. So if I take my just a yardstick. The next thing we're going to do is to establish the position of the center front with relationship to the middle of the leg. Now, after some research and checking on a variety of bodies, what I discovered is that if we take a fourth of the body, let's say from center front to side seam, and we divide it in half, that's a good location for the center front line. So this, I'm going to abbreviate center front. And we draw in a line. And we have a front crotch. Okay? This is a little rough, because we're obviously doing this on the run. Now, for the side of the body, we're going to measure from the center front over to our side seam. And we're going to mark that here. And we're going to measure the hip, fullest part of the hip, center front to side, mark that here, okay? And now what we want to do here, the hip to thigh area is going to stay fitted, but what we want to do is, thank you. Okay, so now we have the leg, the beginning of the torso, and the waist to hip ridge. Now, for men, this area is flat, so you really wouldn't need a dart. But as you can see here, as we bring this thing up, we have some shaping is going to go into the side seam, and some is going to go into the dart. So we can just continue this down, and that is a rough approximation of how we will create the pattern, just to give you sort of an introductory idea.